Anybody seen this movie? Moneyball. 2011 American sports drama film showing Billy Bean and his attempt to assemble a competitive baseball team, the Oakland A's. It's difficult to assemble a competitive baseball team when you don't have any money. And what I want to say is that Billy Bean and his general manager set up sort of a new way of doing things in the sports world. And what they did is they looked at each individual player and they started collecting data on each individual player. And as you can see here, each individual player may have different talents. Now you may ask, what does baseball have to do with agriculture? Does anybody know? Are you still sleeping? Assembling a herd of cattle, for example, could be very similar to assembling a baseball team. Each individual cow has different traits, different things that you can measure, which can be used to produce food efficiently, sustainably, and effectively. My name is Christine Baes. I'm from the Department of Animal Biosciences at the University of Guelph, and I'd like to speak to you today about big data in animal agriculture. Big data meaning a lot of data. When you see a cow, I'm going to talk about cows tonight because cows are my favorite animals. When you see a cow and you think of data, my question to you would be, what sort of things can you measure on a cow? And the first thing you may think of is milk. Milk yield, for example. How many liters of milk does a cow give? With new technologies, we can think about, I mean, cows used to be selected based only on milk yield. But when you think of new technologies and new sensors that are available, we can actually look at the composition of milk. For example, how much calcium does it have? And today, we can even use it to look at the different kinds and amounts of fatty acids in that milk. What other things can we measure on a cow? Does anyone have a Fitbit? Cows have Fitbits too. We can measure their activity. And we can use the data to look at how much our animals are moving around. Does anybody look at what they eat? Does anybody measure what they eat? We can do the same with cows. We can measure their feed intake. Cows, unlike us, ruminate. That means they regurgitate their feed and chew it again, and that lets them sort of use the nutrients and the things inside of the feed that they eat that we can't use. And we can measure it. Body weight, conformation. I know I don't like to stand on a scale, but some people spend a lot of time standing on a scale. But what we can do with cows is actually use three-dimensional cameras that measure actually their conformation, so their fat stores. Methane. Methane is 26 times more potent than CO2. It's a very, very relevant problem in today's world. Now, some of you may think it comes out of the back end of a cow, but that's not actually true. It comes out of the front end, and we can measure it. Genomic information. As a geneticist, I find the idea of DNA absolutely fascinating because it's really the blueprint of life. By collecting a small hair sample on a cow, or any other animal, or any other living organism, actually, we can see into the genetic and genomic architecture of that animal, and we can collect it. We can also collect data on temperature, humidity, the feed that an animal might eat, even its location in relation to its herd mates to follow social interactions between animals. Taken individually, all of these data sources are impressive in their own right, certainly. Taken together, they provide an incredibly powerful basis for producing efficient, healthy, and sustainable food. For example, the idea of individually based cow measurements or individual care for cows, management systems that are based on individual animals. They allow us to reduce the use of antibiotics, for example, reducing these effects of agriculture on our environment. Using analytical approaches such as big data, or using the big data with artificial intelligence, machine learning algorithms, new sensor technologies, we can actually start to understand what this genetic architecture is doing to these traits of interest that I mentioned on the slide previously. We can use the data, the methods, and the sensor technologies to train the next generation of scientists, but also the farmers and the veterinarians who are taking care of our animals. We can use this knowledge gained from these different methods and strategies to increase sustainably the products of our farms. And because of the nature of Moneyball generally, we're not stuck on using baseball. We can use it on cows, and we can spread it to different sorts of species of livestock animals, but also plants. Canada is very good at Moneyball. Last year, Dr. Bonnie Millard was accredited with the Governor General's Innovation Award for her work on immunity in dairy cattle, actually genetically selecting animals that are more immune to pathogens in their environment. Dr. Filippo Miglior was recently interviewed by Wired magazine for his and his team's work on breeding cows that produce less methane, produce the same amount of milk, but have a less dire impact on our environment. And generally, Canada is very well known for its work on genetic improvement of livestock using big data based on analytical approaches that are real, that are sustainable, and that we can use for creating a better environment. This Walrus article says that we exported more than $100 million worth of semen. Now, semen is not the only genetic product that we can create, but we can also export our knowledge, our use of big data, and that has allowed us to propel Canada worldwide as a leader in genetic evaluations. Thank you.